Out. Okay, welcome back, guys, to Let's Play Final Fantasy 13. This is the second time I'm actually having to record this section, but I'll be uploading it during the same time. So I'll be skipping a lot of battles right now, since none of this will be saved onto the next one. But you'll be seeing all these mobs later on in future episodes, since we fight them quite a bit. And yeah, basically the reason why I messed it up is because I accidentally recorded over one of my save points, which caused me to screw up. Oh, not gonna go this way. That's just another item there. There's pretty much no special items around there. Just some regular basic items that you'll see. And here we have a cutscene.
Hey, Saz. Tell me about yourself.
Huh?
Any family?
I have a little boy.
Oh, so you're married?
I was, yeah.
We gotta get you home. Your son needs you. Come on, we'll make it.
It's too late.
Is it the Lassie thing?
How'd you...
You might be a Lassie, but you're still a daddy.
You're right.
So, what's his name?
So it looks like we're going to the Day 11 seaside city of Bodhum, with Saz's backstory about
Hey, Dad.
Why he's here, maybe.
Making a wish, huh? What'd you wish for?
Well, they're never happy. You never smile. So here's what I wished. I wish that you'd cheer up and be like your old self again.
How about that?
Whoa.
Your wish came true.
Yeah. Wow.
Okay, it's my turn to wish.
What for, Dad?
That's my little secret.
Saz?
Huh?
You all right?
Yeah.
Come on, Pops. You really got to keep it together, okay? Now, let's
yeah,
go.
Yeah, come on, Pops.
Now I got kids looking out for me.
Yeah, you got kids looking out for you, man. Well, looks like I'm gonna assume that something has happened to Dodge that is not very, nice. Since why would his dad not be here with him? So we would have saved it there, but... Yeah, basically the master before told us to avoid these mobs if we don't want to fight them. But, we're not going to fight them. No, we are not going to fight them. We're just going to skip on by, but... that one will disappear, but we'll fight that one down there in the next episode of Final Fantasy 13, Turtle Out. Okay, we are back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 13, and last time we were focusing on killing an armadillo in the dumbest way ever. But this time... that's the item we need to get. Well, let's take a look at the map here. Okay, looks like we're gonna go jump down there and get that one. So we're gonna have to kill one of these armadillos again. I assumed this when we were doing it before, but it didn't work out that way. I'm just gonna back up. Okay, I'm not sure if that's gonna be a preemptive strike. I don't think it is, actually. Nope. So it looks like just we're gonna have to build up a stack. It's gonna be quite annoying to do. But it should not be too difficult. I figured the way to beat him was to use the debuffs on him once his shell goes down, but I never really took that chance for some reason, but... And that's what you're basically supposed to do. So whenever you break him, his shield goes down, and that's when you can send in all the D-shells and D-protects to do additional damage to him. And then you should be doing way more damage. Or he's a lot more susceptible to it, so... It only took one extra fight to figure out how to do it. But it worked, so... I'm only gonna be fighting this one, though, so I'm not gonna be fighting all of them, because it's a complete waste of time. He's gonna get a heal off for, Oh, that. It's not good. Yeah, keep it together, man. Okay, we're gonna build up this scale beast. And paradigm shift. Building it up, okay. This is where we're gonna do D-shell, D-protect. As long as they go off, we're in a good shape to do more damage. So now we can start going off doing as much damage as possible to try and kill this guy. As his defenses are down for two of the defenses. So he will be much more susceptible to all attacks. And as you can see, we're doing a lot more damage to him now. I mean, before we had a preemptive strike and we only did like a quarter of his HP on the first stagger. And we're gonna probably be doing more damage right now. Yes, we are. A lot more. So you regenerated his shell. But, we're continuing to do not so good damage, but, it wasn't too bad. We'll just be splitting up the casts here. Oh, wrong one. That might actually not be a good idea. We might lose the bonus here. Looks like we got to keep it. Have to heal him before he gets electroshocked.
Oh, no! I appreciate it. You
follow my lead, huh? Okay. Let's get a stagger bonus in. We can do it. Water, arrow, fire. And he's got not much left, so we're gonna be poning him up right now. He's gonna die within maybe two turns. Probably two more spells right here. Oh yeah, that was pretty good. It's a lot more effective. We're probably not gonna get 5 stars, but... Ooh, 4 stars, not bad. Some technical points, I think. And we are gonna get that treasure that he was blocking. 15 iron shells, alright. That's gonna be good and useful for leveling up. Leveling up our item. Don't touch me. Stay the fuck away from me because I don't want to fight more of you guys. Okay, looks like I got some more treasure chests here. Libra scope, okay. Not very useful, but. Just taking a look around here at the graphics and the landscape.
No, now's no time to be taken in the scenery. Leave a fugitive to catch.
Alright, man. Don't worry. Oh, you're looking at the scenery, too. Okay, we got some chickens here. Just trying to avoid them. We've done enough fighting here, in my opinion. Try and avoid these two, if I can.